Welcome back. In this module, we will cover deploy and configure. We'll start by talking about your pre-deployment planning, then we'll go into deploying, configuring your database or managed instance, as well as how to load data. So the first part of pre-deployment planning is figuring out what you're going to do in Azure. Whether it's a new or existing application is going to have some consequences on how you do pre-deployment planning, as well as how you deploy or migrate. Now, we're not going to spend a lot of time on migration in this series, but we wanted to cover at a high level what the process for migrating if you are deciding to move an existing workload. First, you're going to go through a pre-migration phase. And in this phase, you can use various tools that we'll be sure to share links to discover and assess your on-prem environment or whatever it is that you're considering moving to Azure SQL. In the next phase, you'll actually migrate. And you'll see we have some options using things like the database migration service to actually help migrate you in an online fashion. And in that way, you can only be offline during the cutover period. Lots more information on this that we will share. And finally, after you migrate, there are a lot of testing and things you should do to make sure you're getting the most out of Azure SQL, as well as that everything's functioning the way that it should. So this is just a high-level overview of the things you might need to think about if you're actually migrating your database, not to mention your application, to Azure. Now, once you've kind of made that decision, the next thing you're going to have to do is go through some of the decisions that you saw in the previous module, but figure out what you're going to do for the specific scenario.
So one of the first things you're going to do in this pre-deployment planning phase is decide, how am I going to deploy this? Am I going to use like command line interfaces? There's something called Azure templates you can use, which is very interesting from a command line. Or am I just going to use the portal interface itself? Next, you're going to figure out what kind of option you're going to deploy. Are you going to pick a managed instance? Are you going to use an instance pool? Maybe you're going to do Azure SQL database and pick serverless or hyperscale. So you need to take a look at what we discussed in module one about the different options and capabilities these different deployment options provide, and then make a decision on which target you want to go after. Next, you're going to pick a region in the Azure ecosystem. We talked about that a little bit. And there's several decisions that could dictate on which region you pick. It could be the location of your application. It could be what's best for your network considerations, or it could even be, in some cases, certain Azure SQL options are only available in certain regions around the world. We have guidelines on our Azure website resources on which capabilities of certain Azure resources exist in certain regions. There's tons of regions around the world, so it all depends on your needs. Now, as we talked about in the first module, if you're going to go to Azure SQL database, you're going to have some purchasing model decisions. Remember, for vCore, that's the only choice you get for managed instance. But for database, you're going to decide, should I use the DTU option or the Microsoft recommended vCore option? Now, once you make that decision, let's say you go to vCore and you're going to use Azure managed instance. Then you got to decide on that service tier. We call the service tier also slow or service level objective, which gives kind of like SLAs and different resource limits that we're applying to a given tier. So remember, you might pick general purpose or business critical depending on your availability and resource needs for a managed instance. For database, you have the same choices, general purpose or business critical. And remember, for a general purpose, one of your options could be serverless. Keep in mind, things like business critical are important if you're going to use things like in-memory OLTP applications. And then finally, one of the other choices we talked about for Azure SQL database was hyperscale. And hyperscale certainly is going to be something you're going to consider, especially for very large database deployments. Now, we also mentioned that there is one other option you might consider, and that's the hardware choice. For most customers, they'll use the current hardware generation, which today, as the shooting of what we're doing this, talking about the series, it's Gen 5. But we do have some future hardware choices that you may be choosing after you've decided what the service tier actually looks like. Now, let's say you've made all these choices. What do I do next? Let's say using the vCore model and picking business critical. You will have the ability through the CLI or the portal to pick how many cores you want and the size of your data. Now, this decision could be important, actually, because the number of vCores that you pick in these different service tiers can actually dictate several other things you may not be familiar with, but it's important for you to know. And we call those resource limits. And there are several different resource limits as a SQL Server expert you may be used to that are going to be applicable to your service tier choice or vCore choice. For example, you're used to memory resources for a SQL Server from an operating system or a virtual machine perspective. We will limit the total amount of memory that the SQL Server can use, either for MI or database, based on those choices we set in the previous screen. Whether it's the number of vCores you pick, business critical general purpose could dictate how much memory you get, or even the maximum size of your transaction log, and even things like transaction log rates. The size of tempdb is also dictated by these choices. We have a complete table in our documentation that goes over all these details of things like max concurrent workers, and even your choices of backup retention, because we have things like long-term backup retention that are only available in some situations. So as you make these different predeployment choices, you need to decide what is the right model for you, look at your resource limits, look at the capabilities, and mix this together to decide, you know, which way should I go when I'm going to deploy a managed instance or an Azure SQL database. You know, we've talked about the options. We talked about, Anna mentioned the fact that you might do a new deployment, or you migrate an existing SQL Server deployment, or even third-party applications, databases. And then you need to go through this phase of deciding how you're going to deploy, whether it's visual, what are your options you're going to pick? Are you going to pick managed instance? Are you going to pick database? Are you going to pick various service tiers? What are the resource limits to them? Are you going to pick various hardware options? And go through that exercise of taking your time to ensure that the target you pick is the best. But hey, here's some good news. We're going to show you in part of this series how when you make a choice, there are options you have to move to a different choice depending on your availability and performance needs. So I hope you join us for the next video.